Of 1958 was the beginning of that long voyage, the day I was introduced to Stanground Infant School in Church Street. I remember being taken in by my mum on that first day, also being collected at 3 o'clock when the bell rung. After the first taste of freedom, giving me my independence, this was sink or swim time. I wanted to take the journey alone. I think this was the start of finding my own identity and destiny. Even at this early stage in my life, I was never a playground scrapper. I survived by entertaining my newfound friends, by acting the fool, by imitating the pop stars of the time, or pretending to be a disc jockey. This, I thought, was the road for me. Entertaining those who would listen? The swinging 60s had arrived, the days of flower power, mods, rockers, Vietnam War, television, pop music, drugs, or whatever turned you on. 1965, and I was 12 years old, I ventured out of Stanground on the 303 or 307 Red Eastern Counties bus, which took me to the Odeon Cinema in Broadway, Peterborough. First port of call was the Trick Shop down Fitzwilliam Street, Pea Shooter, Bag of Dried Peas, and Stink Bombs. I'll always remember to this day, sitting upstairs in the stalls of the Odeon, waiting for the film to start. Pop music of the day was being played over the cinema speakers on hearing a new sound. Not the Rolling Stones, not the Kinks. This was the sound of Tamla Motown. The tingle ran down my back even at the early age of 12. The swinging 60s started to give Peterborough teenagers a new lease of life. Fashion, work, identity, music and television was catering for more a younger audience. Programmes such as Thank You Lucky Stars with Brian Matthews, a legend still presenting on Radio 2, Ready Steady Go and Top of the Pops.
Without any snow. And the little children fly their kites, no wind to blow. Neither you nor I, with evils enough to try. That'll be the day when I stop loving you, stop loving you.
radio was getting a new airing for the younger generation of Peterborough. I was fortunate. Christmas 1966, I was brought a pocket transistor radio as a present, complete with leather carrying case. Where I went, the transistor went. With a bit of fine-tuning, I was able to pick up radio stations like the American Armed Network Station and Radio Luxembourg, laying in my bed at night time, listening to Motown, which took me back to the Odeon days when I first heard this music. The sound of young America being broadcast into my bedroom. Names like Stevie Wonder, the Isley Brothers, Junior Walker and the All-Stars, the Funk Brothers, Marvin Gaye, the list got endless. Not only Motown was coming through the airwaves, I came across the sounds of Stax and Atlantic, the Drifters, Otis Redding, Wilson Pickett, Percy Sledge, Solomon Burke, Sam and Dave, William Bell. The list was endless. My mind was working overtime. These major players of the record industry could afford to plug the records on a national scale. Little did I know, until a few years later, what about the hundreds of small record labels who could not afford national plays and distribution? That's another story. The day I got into Northern Soul.
When I stopped loving you, my life became a rage. My mother and father called me to her side. Daughter, you're growing up now.
1968 was the year I was introduced to that big wide world, work. Starting off as an apprentice plumber and heating engineer, being enrolled at Peterborough Technical College, earning £3.50 per week. What was I going to spend all that money on? Need you ask?
You better shop around, oh yeah, you better shop around.
Shop around.
Peterborough was still a small market town then. The development of Peterborough was shortly about to begin. I started going uptown with my newfound friends, taking the 307 or 303 bus from Stanground to Peterborough Bus Park, which is now the county court. My adventure of soul music had begun, hearing the music I'd fallen in love with being played on 7-inch vinyl. The phonograph behind the Bell Hotel was not a very big venue, no alcohol, only bottles of Coke and cheese rolls. But boy, the music was hot. Tamla, Stax, Atlantic. This was the infancy of promotions in soul music in Peterborough. Records were being played three or four times as they were not the abundance of soul records about to fill a four-hour set yet. The Spinning Wheel, which was the Bull and Dolphin near Rivergate, was also a very popular soul event with American soul artists on a regular basis. I was finding soul events springing up all the time. The Acorn Room on Cathedral Square, the Bays, which was also part of the Grapevine, which is now the Argos Shop, Fingal's Cave above the Falcon, the Flamingo Club. I was in my element, finding these new places. This was the start for me, being a mobile disc jockey in Peterborough.
From deep in my soul.
Oh, I enjoy yourself anyway,
Mermaid. Yeah, yeah.
I know, you know, sitting over your beard and everything, you know, you have got three shades of grey.
Yes. Yeah.
It looks good.
Yeah, thank you.
Looks really, really good. And Gary, you're looking good enough.
I'm just looking at envy.
One day, my son, you can grow one like this.
Beard envy, yes, I know. 13 minutes past four here, anyway, on Radio Peterborough. You must keep doing Soul Train. Stay by.
Was the Bull and Dolphin giving me a residency, which I'd done on my own for a number of years.
The Bull and Dolphin. Oh, always been the dear behind. I had to come for an interview to get the job here. And never forget, I had a box of records, singles, and a box of 12-inch. And I came here with a young lady friend of mine. She was a little bit, you know, I don't really want you playing at this Bull and Dolphin. Okay, I said, I'll go in there, do the interview, and then see how we go. Went in there. There's other guys, must have been about 10 or 15. The end of the day, I ended up being approached and got the job at the Bull and Dolphin, being the resident DJ. So as I came out, the lady in question was standing right about here. And on the record boxes. How did you get on? I got it. They want me here at the Bull and Dolphin. Well, her face diminished. We walked down Bridge Street. She was... I'll show you a man that called her at home. He knows he's got some sweet love coming at the end of his
way. The DJ? Oh no! You took the job, the DJ. You know what that means for us. Now we can't see each other. We only meet the evenings anyway. How could you do that to me? Oh, don't you get enough of playing those records of yours over and over anyway? Oh, you know it gets on my nerves and drives me mad. Besides, what do you think your dad will say when you get... He wants you to get a proper job. Oh, I can't even imagine what Mom will say. How are we going to save it for us with you just spinning records? It's just like the tale you've been spinning me over and over. You trail me on and on about this. It's the last straw I'm having.
What do you do? I picked the single case up, the 12-inch record case up, put it on the top of the bridge. Pushed them over, and they went in the river. I walked all the way home to stand ground, and she was followed me. We got near the stand ground. She said, well, I suppose we're finished, aren't we? I said, yeah, I think so. So from that point, 2 days later, I started as a resident DJ here at Bull and Dolphin.
Nightclubs were opening up in the town, such as Annabelle's.
The Met Lounge. Annabelle's. First Peterborough nightclub. Annabelle's. Brilliant. Plus also Cantor's. Great nights. Always used to come here from the Bull and Dolphin. Yeah.
Home nightclub, the Marina, also was packing them in on a Tuesday night, along with legendary all-nighters playing Northern Soul. As with the fleet at Fletton, the youngsters of Peterborough, they were in their element. From Maine to Mexico. It was the early 70s and my DJ career started off at Stangrand Youth Club. They had started disco sessions Friday evenings run by youth club leader Harry Pierce. They had nobody to run it, so I volunteered. This was my first attempt at DJing. I was asked if I would like to carry on as the regular DJ, which I jumped at. We also added into the show a Dracula act, which went down a storm with the junior clubbers and senior youth club members. After a long period of DJing at the youth club, I joined Steve Allen Discotheques, who were getting well established in Peterborough at the time.